We still have like 20 minutes left for the discussions and questions. But for that, I will give a very short comment for the three presentations. The presentations on Mongolian case has shown how much effort they have made to have the Domestic Violence Act in Mongolia. They assume that the so-called open market system or capitalism-based market system has given a lot of influence on the Mongolian women, I guess. So maybe I want to ask that kind of other things later on. And also, Banan has explained about the activities of CSAGA, how they cooperate with the government, how much the how they give the pressure on the government, also having the cooperation with the government and some other NGOs in terms of the support for the domestic violence the victims in terms of the Vietnam context, which has been very different from the other country political system, so which is pretty unique in. Then she explained about that kind of stuff. And the Zufra's presentation is very different from other two presentations. Actually, she has been working with the German international corporations. So that through the cooperation with the international other governments, the support and the corporations, how much actually the civil organization in Pakistan or the Pakistani field work can do work for the women in terms of the violence against women, how much they can work for to protect the women's rights by having the cooperation with international organizations. The three presentations actually explain the media's media campaign, how they can advertise to their own society through the medias, which was pretty interesting to me, because I come from Japan, so we haven't done those kind of activities in Japanese society, which we have to do actually in order to change the society. So this is what I learned from your presentation today. Then now we got like 15 minutes left. We want to take some questions from the floor or some comments from the floor as well. Anyone wants to make comments or make questions first? Be silent. Yes.
Hello. 很高兴今天能够来参加这样子的一个 conference 那我是屏东县儿童少年关怀协会。那我们也跟在这边，我们听到了很多我们共同的经验。那我们都知道，其实妇女很重要，我们也是这样子七年来不断的陪着他们，从他们的经历跟历程里面，让他跟他们一起痛苦，然后跟他们学着如何去选择他们所要的人生方向，这样子。 那我今天在这边听到越南的那个分享，因为我们今年度就是101年，2012年，我们总共批获了17位越南籍的妇女。那这两个月，也就是8月份就有9位。那我们很高兴，今天是9月4号嘛，今天是9月4号，我们很高兴陪伴一位越南籍的妇女。 让他可以安全的到法院去开保护令庭，然后那越南籍的妇女，其实她用了很多她的越南籍的朋友来帮助她，因为为什么？因为她那个相对人并没有参加出庭，她反而是守在那个法院的外面等着她。那那个相对人是非常恐怖的，她要杀了她这样。结果经过我们的一些帮助跟处理，她就从秘密通道。 离开了法院这样。那我今天只是想要，因为这个议题是所谓的倡导， 那我在想说，在我们台湾有那么多的外籍配偶，那包括越南籍的妇女，那我不晓得这些越南籍的妇女，当她要来到嫁到我们台湾来的时候，不晓得在越南的国家有给他们什么样子的一个想法跟建议，因为我们知道暴力都是处在关系里面，那我们知道要有一个好的婚姻就要找一个好的男人，那可是他们如何选择他们的男人，跟在越南的时候怎么去提醒他们说他们要如何去重视这个问题，避免他们来到台湾会有这样子的一个暴力发生，因为这些越南籍的妇女来到我们台湾真的是要面对很多的陌生环境，然后还要适应环境，还要适应那样子的一个婚姻生活，还要适应这个对她家暴的男人，真的是蛮可怜的，然后又延续到下一代目睹儿的一些问题，所以我是想要请教这样子的问题，谢谢。
I answer first question from you. It's how to cooperate with the government. Yeah. You ask me, yes, after that, I answer the second question. Yes, first, how to cooperate with the government is quite difficult in the political context in Vietnam. So civil society or NGO is not terms in the papers in Vietnam. In Vietnam, use other name to call NGO and civil society. Until yesterday, I read in e-news in Vietnam have an article write about civil society. It mean the foreign country, other country want to opposite and fight governments in Vietnam. And now today and yesterday and today, I think have a very big debate about this topic in mass media. Yeah. Government always worry that if civil society big, stronger, if the government is weaker. Yeah. So quite difficult. But for my organization, I think it's quite lucky when we work about only the women and the domestic violence and the human trafficking. At that time, the government prepared for this to law. So I think we cooperate with them because they need information and knowledge from us. They need cooperate with us to help them build strategies about this topic. Yes, so I think we quite lucky. And now I think many new NGOs very strong grow up, and if the topic no opposite with the government is okay. If they have some topic opposite government and the comment for their policy, comment, strong comment, and it's a problem. Yes, I remember some years ago have a new policy only to kill an NGO. And after that, this NGO had to stop, cancel. As but my organization and some other organization work on the topic, no opposite with the government is okay. And the how to cooperate is mass media. Yes, our organizations can have cooperate, can cooperate with mass media very good. We know that journalists always need news. And so we have a library about the biggest library in our organization about the gender-based violence. And always give them the knowledge and the materials and the help them can meet some victims or police or activists who can answer some interviews in their article. It's so if we need some strategies, some campaigns about this topic, we have a network, journalists network, cooperate with us. So quite easy to show our topic. For example, the last month we have Viet Pride. It means LGBT festival. It's very sensitive in Vietnam before, but we can invite many journalists in mass media in the next day. In every mass newspaper and e-news and the TV and radios talk about this event. Yes, for your question, I know now Vietnam Pride in your country is quite a big issue. Many research about this topic in Vietnam, research by NGO and some by government. Until now, only women union have a center to introduce Vietnamese to marriage with a Taiwan man. Yes, every day in the newspaper talk about the issue. But I think the government until now has no policies about this topic. Only NGOs help the girls in the poor village understand that. Living values and how to earn money by many other way. Yes, not because many of them go to marriage as a foreigner man because they want to earn money. Yes, they so poor. Yes, so I think it's the best way is help them have happiness life in their homeland. But I think it's quite difficult. Yeah. Now we are in processing the discuss about a project about this topic. I hope that I can come back to Taiwan for this project.
Thank you. I think your question. To
add on something similar, yeah. Because in Malaysia, the context is a little bit similar but different in a way. In Malaysia, there are a lot of Asian in Malaysia and Vietnam. and then they go through mail order bride services, and then so a lot of Vietnam women have come to Malaysia by force, which they thought that they come to Malaysia to work in a factory, but in fact they are brought in to marry to people. Yeah, I know in Taiwan the context is a little bit different because it's only women union in Vietnam can organize this kind of marriage. So the situation in Taiwan may be slightly a little bit better because the women have a say in this marriage. So can I make a suggestion that perhaps maybe I could strongly suggest for the director when go back to Vietnam to try to actually organize people to go to the rural area, especially those who are in high risk, to educate the girl and the women about the risk, because it's really a very high risk, and a lot of Vietnam girls are actually trapped in Malaysia because of that, and it's very difficult for NGO like us to actually rescue everybody. Thank you.